Welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario RPG. After that game-breaking glitch that we had, it took me a couple hours to figure it out, but after trying a few different things, replacing my ROM, doing the emulator itself, it worked, finally. I downgraded two versions prior to the one I'm currently using for my emulator of the same type of emulator. Ta-da! At first I thought maybe it was just the ROM file being corrupted, but apparently that was not the case. It has more to do with the actual emulator being the fault here. So at least it was, you know, a decently easy fix. So thank God we'll be able to finish this game like it was intended to be. Oops. That's not good for Gina. Amazing. I've actually played through this game before using this emulator in the past and did not realize that because I had changed to a newer version, it might change the quality. Obviously. And next time I start a game on a Super Nintendo, I'll probably have to use this version if it starts to act funny, because wow. 17 experience for that whole fight. What a ripoff. Oh my god. Talk about just... That makes me upset a little bit. I just feel a little ripped off here. I'm talking about seizures. Ah. Holy cow. That's a lot of flashing lights. But hey. There's that star that, that we need. So that's always good, right? That sends us up to 6 out of 7! We only have one more to go. So I wonder, where is that last star? Fancy that. Even the game wants to know. So, we're leaving the Barrel Volcano. Let's go back to Nimbus Land and see what's up here. I don't really know what else I should do when it comes to this. Maybe the king and queen know. That's very smart and thoughtful of them. The wheels on the bus go round and round. Sometimes I wish I was using a joystick. I was playing Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles actually just the other night, and that whole thing, it's Game Boy Advance to GameCube, if you're unfamiliar with the game itself. And Yeah, using an old Game Boy Advance to move in a three-dimension top-down world was kind of frustrating, and it's then that I realized that nowadays, the placement of my thumb on the controller is different than it was back in the day when I was actually using a D-pad. It's funny because it changes the way you can control your character, and I'm still not doing it right. Wonderful. If I remember correctly, there's a Lakitu driving this thing, right? Yeah. Does it say JB on it? What does that mean? Meow? How do you have to repair something like that? What does it need? More water? Awesome. Let's go. Ah, cool. Look at them graphics. I can see Mario's face from here. Oh wow, we've gathered quite a crowd out here at what was it? Mount Vista, I think is what it's called. Yeah, look, he's gonna do it. There's Mario. Oh yeah. I can just imagine. So nice that the text and stuff in the window for speech and all that jazz isn't like glitching back and forth all over the place. Well, let's see, how heavy are these guys? I hit her. Popped in 2 hits, gave me 9 experience, and a mushroom. Totally not worth my time. Oh my god, what about these guys? Haha. Oh god. Ugh! I hate that. Whoa, what? No. Don't think so. Haha. Bitch. Anyway. Whoa, I don't remember. Well, I don't remember this part of the castle ever being here. What the heck? Oh, yeah. Get 42 experience from some of these fights. Like, the last one I got in the upper 20s. And this time it's, 42 experience. I can't say that, I don't want to kind of stick around here and train a little bit. Wow, he can jump. Holy cow. So, as well as not having trouble, you know, any longer with, text glitching, layers acting funny, it also seems that the, slow frame rate, occasional occurrence has dropped. Go through the explanation. Oh god. Okay. Well, at risk of making this an extremely short video, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this one here. 3 cheers for being able to continue. Really happy about that. And now when we cut back, we will pick the first of these 6 doors and find out where we wind up. Thank you for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye!